Hi students, I hope you all are doing great. I'm here with NLM problem solving strategies, I mean Newton's laws of motion problems. Here we are going to solve the problems on tension or normal, it doesn't mean that tension normal problems, problems on tension force or normal force like that. And most importantly, we are going to solve the problems on the constraint motion, that is what are very important in the Newton's laws of motion. Okay, so let me start with Newton's laws of motion. Here to solve the problems, we should know how to draw free body diagram. We should know how to write net force, and we should know or we should identify what is the action reaction phase. Okay, these three important things are required to solve the problems in the Newton's laws of motion. That is what NLM problems. So before that, I will go with some basics of this topic, then we will go with the problem solving session. So here we will go with the Newton's laws. The first law is all about what it is telling of the inertia or the mass. Before that, if I go with the mass, suppose this is the mass I am having. If it is at rest, what is the force acting on this one? The force acting on this one only is a gravitational force. So F equals to gmm divided by r square. So this mass you can give m equals to f r square divided by g into m. This is what we call it as gravitational mass. We call it as gravitational mass. Similarly, if the same mass is in motion or it is accelerating with a, here you can say its mass is f divided by a. So this is what we call it as a inertial mass. This is called as inertial mass. Okay. So if I talk about the Newton's first law, Newton's first law is all about inertia. I divide this law into two parts. One is force, another is inertia. One is force, another is inertia. Okay. So force is what? It is an external agency that keep body either in rest or in motion. It is an external agent. Okay. So inertia, you already know it's a tendency of the body to be in its state. Okay. So there are three. We can call it as inertia of rest or inertia of motion, and inertia of direction. Okay, inertia of rest, tendency of the body to be there in the state of rest unless external force is applied. Inertia of motion, tendency of the body to be there in the state of motion unless external force is applied. Inertia of direction, here body's inability to change its direction by itself. Okay, so in all these cases, external force is required to change their position or state or direction. Okay, so if we go with some examples of first law, suppose you are having the mat. If you want to clean the dusty mat, what will happen? You will just beat with some stick. What will happen? This mat will move on this side, but the particles or dust particles fall down. Why? They want to be there in the state of rest. That is why they are just falling here. Or if you take the branch of a tree where leaves are there, okay. So if you just shake the branch of tree, what will happen? The branch of tree will be in the motion, but leaves or fruits are going to be in the state of rest. They are not ready to change suddenly its state of rest. So what will happen? Because of that, leaves will fall down. This is not a best example of the inertia. Or suppose you are having the glass of water. Okay, it is closed with some plate or something. On that you are putting one coin. If you apply large force when you remove this plate, so what will happen? Coin will not move. Coin will just suddenly come into the glass because it want to continue its state of rest. Similarly, if you want to jump or if you want to go for, if you've seen the athletics, in the long jump or high jump, they cannot jump from there only. They will run from some distance, then they will jump. That is because of what? To change its inertia. Okay. So or else if the person is suppose driving the bike. Okay. So if he is driving the bike, if suddenly if he apply the brake, what will happen? This person will come and fall down here. Why? The body is in the state of motion. Okay. Suddenly when the bike comes to rest, still body in state of motion only. That is why there is a chances he will go forward and he will fall down. Okay. That is what the few examples of inertia. So very important is the second law, where we can get the actual definition of force. According to this law, the force acting on body is directly proportional to rate of change of its momentum. So force equals to rate of change of d by dt of momentum, that is p. So d by dt equals to p is what? Mass into velocity. So force equals to, you can write m is a constant, so you can write dv by dt. This is what we call it as acceleration, mass into acceleration. So, but it doesn't mean that always velocity is only changing. Sometimes mass also may change. But suppose you are having the balloon. Balloon is moving when the air comes outside. That means mass is changing, mass is decreasing. So balloon, suppose it is moving with say some constant velocity, 2 meters per second. Now mass is variable, but velocity is constant. In this case, force will become d by dt of mv. M is variable, v is constant. Take v outside, so it will become dm by dt. Force is equals to dm by dt. If they ask force or if they ask mass or velocity, you can go with this formula. Then what actual formula? F equals to, we are having d by dt of mass into velocity. So apply the product rule here. Take mass constant, then differentiate v, plus take v constant, differentiate m, dm by dt. This is what the actual second law of Newton. So here, if velocity is constant, this is going to be zero. You will get this as a force. Or if mass is constant, this is going to be zero. You will get force equals to m dv by dt as before. Okay. So we have to remember this point. If we talk about the force, we know that it is unit is Newton, and this is the vector quantity having or depending on magnitude and direction. Very important, its effect also depends on point of application. That is very important. Suppose you are having a sphere, if you apply the force here, the effect is very less. It may move to here only. Instead of that, if you apply the force here, if you change the point of application, this will roll and it will travel for the longer distance. So in both cases, effect is different. It is not a same. If you talk about the direction, suppose you are having a body here. If you apply the 10 Newton of force, say its mass is say 5, what acceleration it will get? It will get acceleration as force divided by mass. So you will get 2 meter per second square. Instead of that, when if I change the direction of force, if I apply the force in this direction, say 10 Newton of force only I am applying, but making some angle say 37 degree. If I make angle of 37 degree, so its horizontal component will become what? Its horizontal component will become 10 cos 37. So 10 cos 37 is what? Cos 37 is 4 by 5, 5 to 2, so it will become 8. Now acceleration is 8 divided by 5. Acceleration will become 8 divided by 5. So this is something 1.6, means less than 2. Okay. So same 10 Newton force I am applying in both the cases, but because of the direction, the effect is different. That is why while taking the force, we should be concentrate on point of application and direction in which we are applying. Okay. So one more important thing in the second law is that is all about the impulse, that is what effect of the force, or if you take J as the impulse, how long the force is acting, that is what we call it as the impulse. Okay, it depends on what kind of force is acting also. Suppose you are having a constant force, if the constant force F is acting for some time, say from T1 to T2, if it is acting from T1 to T2, then how you can write the impulse? Impulse is force, force is constant, so no problem, time is changing from T1 to T2. So this is what your impulse, or simply you can write, it is nothing but area under curve, area under the curve. Suppose force is not constant, suppose force is variable. Now what will happen, if force is variable, force is changing like anything, okay? Mm-hmm. You cannot take force as a constant. So time is changing from T1 to T2. In this case, you cannot take the value of force as some constant. Here force is variable continuously. So take a part of this curve, and this is a small time dt. This is what some constant force you can take here. So what you can write? You can write impulse as integration from T1 to T2. T1 to T2. So impulse is what? Force into dt. Okay. This is what's going to give you the impulse in case of variable force. For example, suppose your force is say some 3t square plus 2t, and it is acting from time equals to 1 second to for t equals to 2 second. At that time impulse is equals to what? 1 to 2. What is force? Force is 3t square plus 2t into dt. This is what I am applying this formula. Okay. So here J will become what? It will become 3t square by 3 plus 2 3t cube by 3 divided by t square by 2. 2 will get cancelled. So what will happen? It is changing from 1 to 2. So J equals to will become what? 8 plus 4 minus 1 minus 1. So your impulse will become what? Impulse will become, suppose say some 10. Okay. 10 newton second. Okay, so this is what the impulse, how we can get it. Or we already know that force equals to rate of change of momentum, dp by dt. So if I take dt on this side, this will become f into dt equals to dp. Suppose this momentum is changing from initial to final. I will take momentum changing from initial to final. What I am having? Dp. So this side, time changing from T1 to T2, so F dt is as it is, okay? So here, what is this? This is nothing but your impulse. So you can write this as an impulse. What is this? The integration of dp is what? P. So if you substitute, this will become P final minus momentum initial. So what will happen here? So J equals to, simply you can write change in momentum. So you can get this also. This is what impulse momentum theorem you can call it as. So very important here. Again, if I talk about the force, there are types of forces. One is we can call it as non-contact force. Another is contact force. Non-contact force and contact force. Non-contact force means your gravitational force, there is no contact between the bodies, then also it is acting. Or you can take the magnetic force, two magnets are there is no contact, then also force is there. So like that, non-contact force you know already. Then contact force, in contact force what will come? When the bodies are in contact, then only force will come in action. There are types which you can call it as normal force is also contact force, or tension force is also contact force, or if you take friction, this is also a contact force. Normal in the sense, if suppose you are having a body, this body is acting some force on the floor, and floor will also act some force. This is what, this normal will come in action only when this body is in contact with the surface, otherwise it will not come in action. Okay. It will act some force, say some N, that will also act some force N, okay? But this n we can always take it as equals to mg, but it is not in reality, this is equals to this one. Okay, tension. Tension, if you take two bodies connected by the string, say m1 and m2, here this wire will get some restoring force, that is what in this direction we get, that is what we will call it as the tension. What is the direction of tension? Direction of tension is always in order to reduce its length. Suppose you are having a wire here, if you connect two bodies, its tension direction is always towards the center, means to reduce its length, to decrease its length. Okay, so friction, so you already know it will come in action only when there is a contact between the surface and the body. Okay, that is what. So we'll go one by one later. So next is Newton's third law. This is very important, where we can find the action reaction for actually. Okay, so what this will say, this will suggest for every action there is an equal and opposite reaction. Okay, if this is a force acting on one body, if it is, you can say AB, that body will also act some force FBA. So what they will say, FAB is equals to minus FB, force acting on A by B is equals to force acting on B by A. But this law is not only this much, there are four important things we have to remember here. Is the magnitude of force should be same. Okay, should be same, that is, so you already know. Direction should be opposite. Okay, third one, it is very important, it acts on two bodies, not on a single body, it should act on two bodies. And one more very important thing is nature of force should be same. The force nature should be same. If one is contact, another should be contact. If one is non-contact, another should be non-contact. So whenever if we get one action reaction pair, we have to check all these four. If all these four apply, then only we can consider it as the action reaction pair. Suppose you are having a body of mass m. here. Okay. So what is acting in upward direction? Normally is acting. What is acting in downward direction? Mg is acting. Is this normal and mg are action reaction pair? We can check magnitude. Okay, magnitude is same, no problem. Magnitude is same. First one is correct. If we talk about the second one, direction should be opposite. Obviously, direction is opposite. So second is also correct. It acts on two bodies. Is it correct? Is it acting on two bodies? Say normal is a force acting on this body. Say you can call it as body A by the surface. Okay. What is mg? Mg is also force acting on the body A due to earth. Then these two forces are not acting on two bodies, it is acting on the same body, so third is not going to applicable here. That means these are not action reaction pair. Actually its reaction is somewhere here, n. We can simply take they are equal, but this mg is not its reaction. There is one more is there, N, that is the force applied by the body on the surface. This is the force applied by the surface on the body. These two you can take action reaction pair, but not these two. One more thing, if you check about the fourth one, nature of force. What is this nature of force? N is a contact force. Normal is a contact force. What about this one, Mg? Mg is not a contact force, gravitational force. It is not a contact, means it is a non-contact force. Again, this is also going to be not applicable. Out of four, two are not applying here. That means this is not action reaction pair. Okay. So whenever action reaction pair comes, we should be check with all these four. Then only we can go. Remember these four steps. So then, if you are taking a body, this is earth and body A is the same example I am taking of mass m. So here normal is acting and here mg is acting due to the center. Now we can check action reaction pairs here. P
This n is normal or force acted by the surface of earth on the body. So body will also some normal on the surface. This is what the force acting by the, or this was gravitational force mg, and this will also act some gravitational force, say capital mg, mass of the earth into acceleration due to gravity, mass of body into acceleration due to gravity. These two you can take it as action reaction pair, or these two you can take it as action reaction pair. Remember, action reaction pair is a very important in our daily life. Suppose where you can see this one. Suppose there is a person, suppose he is walking. If the person is walking, obviously you put mask also, very important nowadays. So if this person is walking, if you want to walk, you are not going to apply any force in forward direction. Instead, you will apply the force on the ground in backward direction. So this leg is not responsible for your walk, or this is not giving you a forward force. You will apply the force here on the ground. You will apply the force on the ground. So ground will also apply some force. So this reaction of the ground is responsible or is giving some force. If you take its component, this will become what? Horizontal component of reaction of the earth. This is what? Vertical component of the reaction of the earth. So this vertical component is responsible to balance your weight or mass, and this horizontal component is responsible for what? Responsible for your motion. So these action reaction forces responsible for your walk. Okay. Suppose we are having a horse, and this horse, the horse is connected to a, it is connected to a cart. So suppose you are having a cart over here, having the wheel. So if horse mass is say mh and cart mass, you can take it as mc. Now again, if we look at the action reaction pair, the horse will not apply any force on the forward direction. It will apply force on the ground. Here it is applying force. Because of this action, there is a reaction by the ground. This is what the ground reaction, that is what we take it as a force. If you take this horizontal components FH, or this is what the vertical component force phi. Okay, so the net force acting in forward direction is, you can take it as just FH. If this move in forward direction, here we are connected with some string or something, so obviously tension will generate. If you talk about this horse, the tension is in this direction. If you talk about this cart, again tension is in this direction. If you talk about the cart, it is having the mass m mc, and this wheel will get some friction. You can call it as the F in opposite direction. So now if I talk about only horse, I will take horse as a system. If I take only horse as a system, what is the acceleration of this one? What is the net force? F net on the horse is, what is the forward direction force? FH. Is there any force acting in backward direction? If you look at, tension is there. If I talking about only horse portion, if I take horse as a system, tension is acting here in opposite direction. So net force is FH minus T. So if you want to find the acceleration of the horse, acceleration of horse is force H minus T divided by mass of the horse. Similarly, if you talk about the cart, what is the net force acting on the cart? F net is equals to, is there any forward force? Yes, if I take this as a system, there is a forward force, that is tension. Is there any backward force? Obviously, friction is there, Ft minus F. So this is what the net force acting. So if you want to find acceleration of cart, is equals to T minus F divided by mass of the cart. Since these two are connected to each other, so I can equate acceleration of cart is equals to acceleration of horse, because they are connected, they are moving together. So what you can write? You can write T minus F divided by MC is equals to FH minus T divided by MH. Note this formula very important. Or don't remember the formula, just you can remember what exactly happened. Okay. Or if I take this as a whole system, not individual, because taking the system is in your hand. You can take this system. Okay. So if I take this as a whole system together, cart and horse, so what is the net force? Net force acting is forward force is FH. Is there any backward force? Of course, tension is there, but equal and opposite you can cancel. So here friction is there opposite, okay, minus F divided. This is what the net force. So if you want to find the acceleration, acceleration is FH minus F divided by mass of cart plus mass of horse, MC plus MH. This is what the acceleration of the whole system. If you take individual, this is what the acceleration you can equate. Positive is there, they may ask the friction, they may ask the tension, or what is the force acting on the horse, or they may ask mass, anything. Okay. So again, don't buy at the formula, just remember how we can get or how we can draw the formula. Okay. So if we know about this one, to find action reaction phase, already you know we should know how to draw the free body diagram. Remember, in Newton's laws of motion, to solve any problem on element, drawing its free body diagram is very very important. Okay. So if I take one body, if suppose you are having a body A, or so what are the forces acting on this one? That is what we call as free body diagram. One normal force is acting, that is the normal acted by the surface of the earth on the body. Obviously, this body will act some normal force on the surface. Apart from this, mg is also acting. This is what the total forces acting on the bodies. We can, again, these two are the action reaction phase. These two are not action reaction phase. But this is equal, so you can write n equals to mg. Okay, so by magnitude you can take these are equal, but they are not action reaction phase. Suppose I am having two bodies connected here, one is A, another is B. Now if I want to draw the free body diagram, normal is acting, here normal is acting, one more normal is acting here, obviously this is equals to say M1, M2 if you take, so M1G, here it is, M2G. Apart from this one, this body A will also act some force on B, that is what force or normal acting on B by A. This B will also some force on this one, that is what normal acting on A by B. If I draw only free body diagram of B, what will happen? Free body diagram of B will become a normal acting acted by the surface on the body and normal acting by the body on the surface. Obviously mg is there, so one more what extra is coming is normal acting on B by A. It is in this direction, normal acting on B by A. Since these two are equal, you can simply take this much also. Okay, this is what the free body diagram. Or if you take some three bodies, suppose you are having a body B, here you are having body C, and this is body A. If I ask you to draw the free body diagram of B, what are the forces acting on the B? Obviously, normally is acting on B, okay, due to the surface. Here, C body is also there. That will also apply for some force. That is what normal acted by the C. Apart from this, one more normal is there, that is equals to mg, that is mass of body into acceleration due to gravity. And this A will also act some force on B. So it is a normal acting on B by A. So this is what the total free body diagram of the B. Okay. Similarly, if we take a body on the inclined surface, if you take the body on the inclined surface, suppose you are having the inclined surface, if body of mass m is there, here how we can draw the free body diagram? What is acting in downward direction? Mg. Obviously this is not equals to normal, very important here. So this is what normal acted by the surface on the body, and the normal acting by the body on the surface is in this direction. This is what the normal. Here you cannot take n equals to mg like this. Okay. So what will happen? You have to take component of this one. If this is angle theta, this will become theta. So its component is here is what? It is mg cos theta. Here its component is mg sin theta. So what is the normal? Normal acting is mg cos theta. Then what is it? This is the force acting on the body. You can take force in forward direction as mg sin theta. Okay. Or if you want to acceleration of this body, you can take F equals to ma. So mg sin theta. So mm will get cancelled. Acceleration of body on the inclined surface is g sin theta. Simply we can take like that. Or if you take a body which is connected like this, okay. Suppose if you want to draw the free body diagram of this one, this is what here. What is the force acting is downward, and here something is connected with the string, so tension will act here. Okay, this is T, this is T. Here it is touching this wall, so wall will apply some normal force. And this will also apply some normal force. This is what the free body diagram of the this. Okay. So, or if you take two bodies in a container, suppose this is one sphere, and take another sphere here. Now, here free body diagram is what? So many forces are acting. Obviously, you can take M1. This you can take M2. In downward, M1 G there here. M2 G is there. This will apply force on the wall. Wall will also apply force on this. Here this will apply force on wall, and this is what N. Similarly, there is one more force, that is M2 is acting some normal force and M1 is acting some normal force. So here this surface will act some normal. Here though it is not contact with the surface, so no need to draw normal here. So this is what equals to mg. This is how we can draw the free body diagrams. If you are perfect with drawing the free body diagrams, you can easily identify what is action reaction field. Suppose if you take here, these are the what action reaction field. These two are the what action reaction field. These two are action reaction field, but not these two. Obviously we have discussed about that one. They are not the action reaction field. Okay. So this is what all about how to draw the free body diagram. You can take some examples with yourself. You can draw the free body diagram, because in solving NLM problems, free body diagram is very, very important. Already knowing the force, so there are normal force, then tension, then the friction force. Okay. Now we will discuss how to find the normal forces, or how they can ask the questions on the normal force. Suppose you are having a body of mass M. You know that the normal is acting in this direction, and some mg is acting in this direction. The mass is M. Suppose this force is some other force acting in this direction. Obviously, the normal value will get changed. Or if some force is acting in this direction, obviously value of normal will get changed. Okay, or they may connect two bodies and they will ask you to find the what is the normal acting from body A to body B. So they can ask anything here. Suppose if I take the body of mass M, a force of 10 Newton is acting on this body. Okay. Say its mass is say some 5 kg. Now what is the normal acting on this body from the surface? So due to surface, some normal will act here. So how we can find this one? What is the downward force? Downward force is mg. So 5, I will take g as a 10. So this will become what? This will become equals to 50. If this force is not there, normal is equals to what? Normal is equals to 50. But since this force is there, suppose if it is making some 37 degree angle, we have to take its components. You have to take its component. This is acting in this direction, this is acting in downward direction. That means in downward direction, mg is also there, this component is also there.
So your normal is going to equal to this plus its component. What is its component here? Here it is 10 cos 37. Here it is 10 sin 37. Okay. So what is the normal then? Normal is equals to net downward force is equals to net upward force. What is the net downward force? This mg plus this component is in downward direction. If you take its component, it is in downward direction. So what will happen? It will become 10 sin 37. So this is what the total normal is 50 plus 10 sin 37. Sin 37 is 3/5. So what will happen? It will become 56 newton. Okay. So similarly, if the force is acting in this direction, suppose I will take say 5 kg mass only. So if the force is acting in this direction, so what will happen? What will be the normal? Obviously, normal is acting here. So this mg 50 is acting in downward direction. So again, I will take 10 newton only. 10 newton force only. If you take its component, again I will take 37 degree. This is what 10 cos 37. Here it is. Now it is not in downward direction. It is here, means it is in upward direction. So it is 10 sin 37. Okay. Now what is a normal? Normal is not 50. 50 is there or mg is there in downward. But this is not there in downward direction. So net downward force is not 50 plus something. It is 50. Opposite direction means you have to take minus 10 37. So what it will become? Mg minus 10 into 3/5. This will become what? 50 minus. So 6. So this will become 44 newton. Okay. So this is what the net downward force. Now if you look at here. What is the friction force? Frictional force is mu s into n. So what is the friction? Mu s into what you are getting here? You are getting mg plus you can take some 10 sin 37. Here f is mg again mu s into n. Mu s, but n is what? N is mg minus 10 sin 37. So if you look at the friction, here friction is increasing, here friction is decreasing. That is why if you see in the bags or luggage bags or something, so if the person always used to pull it, so it is not pushing. That is why the pulling is easier than the pushing. Because friction is less in case of pushing, pulling, and friction is more in case of pushing. That is why here less friction is there. That is why we prefer pushing. That is why the bags are made to pull, not to push. Okay. Suppose if I take another example, suppose you are having a body here. Okay, say mass is again 5 kg, one force is acting in this direction, say 10 newton, another force is acting here, 10 newton. So both are making angle 37 degree only. Both are making angle 37 degree only. Now what is the normal? Normal is, one is to their mg, okay. Its component here it will come in downward direction, that is what n sin 37. Its component will come here. That is what? 10 again sin 37. Now what is net downward force? Net downward force is mg. This is also downward. Plus 10 sin 37. This is also downward. So plus 10 sin 37. So this is what the net downward force. Because two forces are acting on the body, so obviously normal will increase. So similarly, if you take the connected bodies, suppose you are having one body here and another body here. Okay. So now it is say mass 5 kg. You can take this mass as 3 kg. Now what is the normal acting on second body due to first body, or we can take this as a this as V. What I want? I want force or normal acting on body A due to B. So how we can find this one? How we can find this? Suppose a force of say 10 Newton is acting. Okay. Now, very simple. What is the acceleration? Acceleration of the body is take whole as a system. If you take whole as a system, F equals to 10 Newton is there. Acceleration is 10 divided by mass. Mass is 5 plus 3. That is 8. 5 plus 3. That is 8. So your acceleration will become what? Acceleration will become, what is its mass? Its mass is 5. If system acceleration is 5 by 4, then acceleration of A is also 5 by 4, acceleration of B is also 5 by 4. So what you can get? The force acting on A is nothing but mass of A into acceleration. Mass of A is what? 5. What is acceleration? 5 by 4. So what you will get? You will get 25 by 4. This is what the normal acting on A by B. This is what the normal acting on A by B. Similarly, if I take three bodies connected, so body A is there 2 kg, another body 2 is there 3 kg, another body C is there 5 kg. Okay. Say some 20 Newton of force is acting on this one. What they are asking is normal acting on 5 kg due to 3 kg. What is normal acting on 5 due to 3 kg? Okay. Now find the acceleration of the system. Acceleration of the system is mass divided force divided by mass. So what is the force? 20. What is the total mass? 5, 3 plus 2, so 10. So you will get acceleration as what? 2. Now you can easily find what is the force acting on this one. Force acting on this one is mass of the body is 5, acceleration is 2, obviously 10. So this is what the normal acting on 5 due to 3, that is 10. Or if you go in another way, what is the mass of these two bodies? 5. What is the acceleration of these two bodies? It is 2. So what will get? Again 10 only. These two are acting the force of 10 Newton. So same you are getting. So this is how we can find the normal acting on one body from the other body. They may ask between these two also. At that time we have to take 3 into acceleration or 2 into acceleration. Like that we can solve these kind of problems. Or suppose you are having a body which is there on the inclined surface. I will connect two bodies. Okay. If I connect two bodies, this is 2 kg, this is 1 kg. So what is the net downward? Net downward is 3g sine theta. Or not 3g, total mass into acceleration. If you take its normal component, this will become what? 3g sine theta, sorry, cos theta. So here in this direction it is what? 3g sine theta. Now what is the acceleration? Acceleration is force. Force acting is 3g sine theta. So what is the mass? Mass is total 3. So you will got acceleration is g sine theta. Now what question they are asking? They are asking the question normal acting on 2 by 1 means this normal they are asking. If we are having two bodies here, normal acting on 2 by 1. We will see what normal is acting. So what is the force acting on 2? Force acting on 2 is mass of this, okay, mass of this into acceleration. Into acceleration is g sine theta. Okay. So what you can write? You can write net force is g 2g sine theta. What is the opposite force? Opposite force is nothing but n is equals to. Is equals to what? Is equals to individual mass. Individual mass is what? 2. Into acceleration is what? G sine theta. So these two will get cancelled. N will become 0. It is true. When two bodies are on the inclined surface, when the two bodies are there like this, so it is not possible for this body to act force on this one. It will not act force. So that is why the normal acting by this body on this body is going to be 0. So that what we are
getting. Okay. Similarly, if we talk about the normal forces, if I take another example, suppose you are having a spear. If you are having a spear, important one. So if I take spear for example, so it is kept on from corners. Okay, so distance between these corners is 6, you can take 6 meter, and radius of this is say 5 meter. Now what is the question? Question is, what is the normal acting on? What is the normal acting on a spear due to corners? So due to corners, what is the normal acting? This will act normal in this direction. This is what is normal. This will act the same normal force in this direction. That is what is normal. So here you have to find the n. So say mass of this is say take some 5 kg. Okay. So what is the net downward? Net downward is 5 into 10. It is 50. Suppose it makes some angle theta here. So what is the normal acting? Downward is equal to upward. It's component. If this is theta, this is going to be a theta. What is this? This is n cos theta. Because of this, again n cos theta. So what we will get? Total upward force is 2n cos theta. So total upward force is 2n cos theta. That is going to equal what? That is going to equal downward force, that is 50. Then how to find this cos theta? If you take this triangle, if this is 5, this total is what? This total is equal to 6, where half of this is what? 3. If you take sine theta or cos theta here, if you take the sine theta, what is sine theta? Sine theta is opposite divided by hypotenuse, that is 3 by 5. So theta is what? Sine inverse of 3 by 5. Theta is sine inverse of 3 by 5 is nothing but 37 degree. Substitute here 2n. 37 degree is what? Cos 37 equals to 50. So 2n equals to cos 37. Cos 37 means 4 by 5 equals to 50. So n equals to 50 into 5 divided by 4 into 2 divided by 4 into 2. This is what the normal you are going to get. So these kind of problems we have to concentrate. Suppose if we take the NEET 18 question, that is what a body is kept here, say its mass is n, and this wedge or this inclined surface is only moving with acceleration a, making some angle theta. The question was, what should be the acceleration in order to keep this body not to slide? Means body should not slide, so then what should be the acceleration? So here what is there? Mg. So if this is theta, so this will become what? Mg cos theta. Here Mg sin theta. Now the force acting on this one is what? F equals to Mg sin theta. Then what is acceleration? Acceleration is G sin theta. Now this A is there in this direction. You take its component. If this is theta, it will also theta. So what it will become? This will become A cos theta. So obviously acceleration of, this is what, acceleration of mass, acceleration of wedge is what? Acceleration of that inclined surface is, you can take A cos theta. A cos theta. If this should not slide, means this acceleration should be equal to this, then only there is no relative motion. That means they are moving together. So if I equate the acceleration, A cos theta equals to G sin theta. So A equals to what? You take this side, so it will become G tan theta.